This is adapted from a short story by someone named Poe Ballantyne. I call it A Kiss for Miss Ellie. Yeah, I'm what you'd call ugly. Bad skin, scrawny, big plastic glasses with wide Coke bottle lenses. Just 19, living at home, taking some med courses. I'm working the swing shift at Serendipity, you know, the old folks home. I'm a nurse's aide. I work from midnight on, not much to do, just make the rounds, checking on all those old folks. I heard they'd hired another nurse's aide, to work the night shift. Then I ran into her the other night. Well, really, almost. It was a slow night, and I was up on the third floor doing wheelchair wheelies up and down the halls. So far, three times, the front wheels never touching down, a new personal record, and I would have kept going, but turning the corner, I almost ran into her as she was coming out of the elevator. I braked hard and lurched forward, the front wheels touching down, sad to say, but I wasn't thinking about that. She was young and pretty, and more annoyed than startled. Way to go, asshole, I thought to myself, how to make a good first impression. Her name tag read Amanda. She said, I need some pillowcases. So I nodded, led her to the linen closet down the hall, said, be my guest. Thanks, she said, and looking at my name tag, added, Jess. They got me assigned to the second floor, but we're out of pillowcases. She took a few. No problem, I muttered. She was already headed back to the elevator when I added, see you around, Amanda. She turned, flashed a smile at me, and said, good night, Jess, as the doors closed. Oh, man, the rest of the night I couldn't stop thinking about her. I made my rounds, did my charts, and wrote off my chances. Hell, once she met Reynaldo, she'd succumb to his charms just like the other nurse's aides. Curly blonde hair, suave, 21, and in med school for real, not just taking a couple of courses like me. Well, as the week went by, I'd see her in the break room now and then, and there'd be Reynaldo chatting her up, so I'd just go the other way. Then one night, Amanda came up to me in the break room, her face all red. She wanted to know, is there something wrong with me? I got out a quiet no. So why don't you ever say hello or anything? I just stammered, I don't know, my head down. When I looked up, those green eyes were looking right through me, and I looked back, really looking at her, but then I got nervous and looked away again, saying something about looking after one of the residents, and I left. But then something happened that brought Amanda back up to the third floor to see me again. I could see she was upset. She was biting her lip. Amanda had never had a resident die on her before. She told me it was Miss Ellie. Could I help her clean up the body? Well, I'd always liked Miss Ellie. She was sharp and feisty, had a great attitude, always flirted with me, called me her boyfriend, but we all go sooner or later. No surprises there, working in a place like this. I said, sure. I had prepared the dead before. Twice since coming here, residents often died at night in their sleep. I knew what to do. When you die, all your muscles relax and you evacuate. That's what we call it. So we put on latex gloves, removed her soiled gown and the soiled sheet under her, washed her clean, put her in a fresh gown, a clean sheet under her, then hurried before rigor mortis set in, to insert her dentures, close her eyes, fold her arms and hands over a top sheet. When we were done, I kissed Miss Ellie on the forehead. Amanda asked, why'd you do that? I said, she was a good lady, I liked her. Then I said, good night, Miss Ellie, like I always had when leaving her room. And as we left together, Amanda turned and repeated, good night, Miss Ellie. Our shift was almost over. Amanda asked what I was doing later. I shrugged. She said, I need a drink. Now, I knew Amanda was only 17, and hell, I'm only 19 myself. I suggested Reynaldo's 21. Amanda frowned. I don't like Renato. And then she smiled at me and kissed me on the cheek. So I said, hey, I got this friend who's older. Thank you.